In the heart, there is a glimmer of light, because love holds the memories that gently keep flowing forever. Ew. Hello, I'm Danica from Project Grace, and I have a bone to pick with sympathy cards. Hope it helps to know that many heartfelt thoughts are with you and your family. No. Heartfelt thoughts. There it is again. Go out to you in this time of sorrow, too deep for words. I think that one actually is the most true. When people try to fix or offer their own words after the loss of a loved one, they are often stumbling just to know what to say. Things blurred out like, you know, at least they had a good life. God has a plan. Time heals all wounds. Things that just really aren't helpful for the griever. I like to call those Band-Aids. Band-Aids, you know, you put it over a wound. But the Band-Aid isn't what makes the thing heal. It just covers up what's hurt. I think people try and make us feel better with great intentions. But when they say things that are awkward, it's just better left unsaid. That's why I am talking about this today. What do you write in a sympathy card and what do you not write? So you've seen a couple examples of what not to write, but I'm going to show you a couple of examples of what to write or help you branch off from your own creativity and jumping point to fit the relationship with you have with the person and the loss, the circumstances of their loss. This one is one that I designed, and I'll be showing you several of these today, but it has all the words that are Band-Aids. I know exactly how you feel. That's a great one because it totally takes the focus of comforting them off of them and puts that onto you. People say the strangest things, right? What's the solution? I'm here whenever you need a hug instead. It doesn't fix their pain, but it acknowledges that, you know, it's there. They don't want a quick fix. That means that their loss and their love was cheap. What can you offer instead of words? Here's another one. This is a painting that I made with my mom. So inside, I actually have instructions for the sender, not the receiver, which is kind of unique. So it says, treasuring the memories with you as we look back on a life well lived. So these are some prompts for you to write your memories in. A time they made me laugh, a time I'll never forget, something I'll always remember about them. So what are those memories? I think it really helps a griever to hear about their lost loved one, how they'll be remembered, and it gives them something to hold on to. There's another problem, though, is that when there's a loss of a young one or a baby, or maybe a baby who wasn't even carried to term, there's no memories to share. So what do you say to them? This is a card I created, and this is a collage. So inside, grieving, not for what was lost, but for what could have been. What a special, specific kind of grief that is, right? It needs to be acknowledged. And so I just simply said, I wish there were words that could help ease the pain. I'm grieving with you today. I'm grieving with you, I think is a really powerful statement, but I suggest only offering that statement if you're willing to be there with them in their grief, then they know they're not alone. A lot of people say, I'm here for you if you need anything, you know, and while that's really appreciated to a griever, I think it's hard to quantify, like, if I need anything, like, I'm not going to ask you to go above and beyond or come over to my house at 2 a.m. when I'm upset, or what do you mean I'll be there? Like by phone or like only when I'm happy or, you know, only when I'm sad. What does that mean? And so I created this card. So it's almost like someone was writing down a brainstorm on a notebook piece of paper. So this is when you, and these boxes are left open for the sender to check, actually. When you want to talk, check. When you need anything, check. When you need a friend, check. When you want some company, that's a big one, actually, check. When you need help with anything, check. I know, especially for my mom, she had younger kids, and we needed a lot of help when things broke because my dad was a handyman. So that's a really big one. Inside, I'm here for you, check. So do you see how that defines what I'm here for you means for the sender and the receiver? That's a really big deal for them. So in your card, whether yours and mine or not, what do you mean I'll be there for you? Maybe write down some things. A great idea too is offering a coupon book, you know, so like getting a couple of sheets of paper and writing down like good for one night of babysitting when you need to pamper yourself, good for one fixing something that's broken. Those are really quantifiable things. Even if they don't end up using that specific coupon, that gets them thinking of like, oh yeah, I can call so-and-so because I really need this right now. Here's another one. This is a pretty piece of art that I do with my online school. This is one of the exercises we're talking about, letting the tears come. So this is giving our hearts permission to express the pain and sadness that we're going through. A lot of times when you've just experienced loss, you're kind of on survival mode. And so accessing those emotions, it's almost like there's higher priorities. There's like, breathe, get to the next moment. So that survival mode really kind of dampens that expression of grief until later. And I think the hard part is later is often when the people aren't showing up anymore with casseroles. And so who will be around then? And so this card is to help with that. So it says, my heart hurts for what you're going through. Please know that your tears are okay with me. Call me anytime. Here's our last one. I wish there were an easy button that could make it all okay. Until then, I'm with you in the process, both the messy and the beautiful. So what this card is talking about, I wish I could just take away your pain, but I can't. And so I know this will be a long-term process. And so I'm with you. I'm with you there. So I hope that gives you some ideas of things you can write in a card, expressing sympathy. Words often fall short, but they're also powerful, and they're powerful to wound. They're powerful to cover up someone's hurts, and they're powerful to give expression to what needs to be said, to what can be helpful for them. So don't be afraid of writing something. If you don't know what to say, just write that. Give your number. Leave a gift card. There's a lot of ways that you can tangibly help a griever without having to say much. So I hope that encourages you and gives you some ideas. If you're looking for sympathy cards, I have all of these on my Etsy store, and I'll leave the link in the notes. There's printable versions of these as well. So if you are on a short timeline, you can do the printable version. They're a lower cost, but they do require some cropping. But that's definitely an option for you if you're short on time. See you later.